Good morning guys, welcome again to my channel. This morning I'm standing in the bridge of Kretek. This bridge is connecting you from Yogyakarta to Parang Tritis Beach. And today is Sunday, the 17th of July 2022. Today I will go for my exploration to a specific hill. The name of the hill is Surocolo, and then the name of the peak is Merangi. There are many interesting things that we could see over there. So the location of the hill I could show you from here. It's about over there. Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
It's over there.
Okay, I will explore this today. And then slightly I could tell you that there are many things that we could see there. The first one is the nice view, interesting view of the beach of Parang Tritis, from Parang Tritis to Pandan Simo. And then beside that, we could also see some Japanese bunkers that were built during the Second World War. Okay, I skip the video here, and then we can meet again in the location.
From the bridge, I just need to go to the east, following the upstream of the Opak River, and then finally I will come to this point. At this point I have to turn right, going up to a quite narrow road up the hill for about 30 minutes, and then finally I come to this place. In front of me, there are some information boards made by the Center of Culture Preservation, or in Bahasa Indonesia, we call them BPCB, Balai Pelestarian Cagar Budaya. The boards show about the spread of 20 Japanese bunkers on the hill built by the Japanese military between 1942 and 1945. All the bunkers have never been used up to now, since Japan was defeated in 1945 by the bombing of the two cities, Hiroshima and Nagasaki. As we know from the Indonesian history, that Japan military occupied Indonesia only for 3.5 years. We never found any Japanese architecture building in big cities in Indonesia. But the Japanese military left so many bunkers in several strategic locations. One of the locations is here on 350 meters above sea level hill of Surocolo in Pundong, Bantul, Yogyakarta, Indonesia. From the information board made by BPCB, we can read that the 20 bunkers are spread in 12 hectares area on the hill. Some of the bunkers were made by carving the tufa cliff, and some others were built in cement concrete material. The Japanese military built the bunkers here on purpose to anticipate the landing of the marine troops of the US and the Allies from the South Sea. So what are actually the function of the bunkers? The first one, there is one bunker located right facing the sea line for posting the heavy artillery like cannon. This bunker has a big square hole facing the sea.
Okay, guys, now I am on the side of the road in the peak of Merangi in Pundong. Behind me, you could see this is the Japanese bunker. Yeah, the Japanese bunker, but local people call it Gua Jepang. And then over there, yeah, actually, that is the sea. You could see Parang Tritis Beach from here with a very clear weather. Well, this is the Japanese bunker that was built during the Japanese occupation. And exactly this bunker is facing the sea, the Parang Tritis Beach. You could see the beach. I think it's very nice. The weather is very clear. And then, okay, you could see also the mouth of the river. That is the Opak River. Yeah, the coastline is very clearly white. And then there is also a new bridge crossing above the Opak River. Okay, and then let's see here.
The second use, there are also 7 bunkers that were used for placing light machine gun located on the slopes of the hill. The next, there are 3 bunkers were used for watching or spying on of the arriving enemy, indicated with towers on top of the roof. We can see that this tower has 4 holes in 4 directions that can be used for watching or firing the enemies. And the next, there is 1 bunker that was used for preparing the food for the Japanese troops. This is indicated by the existence of the fireplaces and chimneys in the bunker. And finally, there are 8 bunkers without holes at all. These bunkers are located close to the bunkers with the machine gun. These 8 bunkers were used for storing the ammunition and the weapons. There is also an additional information that actually the access between 1 bunker and another was connected by the artificial ditch. They put the 2 fast stones aside to the left and to the right, forming access between bunkers. So the access road between bunkers is like a dry canal that can be stepped on. Well, I'm trying to walk along the ditch from 1 bunker to another, and I feel it is quite tiring. And finally, I come to the other bunker, and I see that this bunker is broken already. The upper structure is broken. You can see that actually this bunker has no hole at all. This is for the ammunition store and weapons. Okay, guys, above all, my conclusion is that from the Japanese bunkers existing on this hill, now we understand how well prepared the Japanese troops were to fight against the US and their allies in the Second World War. Okay, guys,
Now I can show you the view of a white coastline of Parang Tritis from another direction. You could see there is an inscription on the right. It says Goa, Jepang. Well, besides visiting a cultural heritage of Japanese bunkers and enjoying the white beautiful Parang Tritis coastline, you can also have some beautiful photo spots here. There are many beautiful spots that you can use for having a selfie photograph. Don't worry guys, that was not the last beautiful place. We still have another one. Yes, it is Puncak Kahyangan, or a place above the sky. In front of you, there is a Y junction. Just try to take the right one that goes to the Puncak Kahyangan. Here, you could enjoy a very complete and beautiful view of the white Parang Tritis coastline. You can also see the view of the estuary or the mouth of the Opa River quite clearly. Local people say that this place is quite crowded before the evening. They come here for enjoying the sunset. Just have a look on the screen that there are also many facilities for the visitors to enjoy this place.
Okay guys, that was my exploration today. I hope you could enjoy my video, and thank you for watching. Thank you for the like, sharing and subscribing. I hope you are all fine. If someday, if you want to go with me to this place, I think just contact me. We could go together. I could be your friend. Thank you. All the best.